Hello everyone. In this video, I'll discuss about cash flow statement, its format, and the uses of cash flow statement. So let's start with the cash flow statement. First of all, we have opening bank balance. Now, this is the balance which you have in your account when you people are making this statement. Now, if you make it for March, so what is the balance in your account that you will enter here? If suppose you say you have just started the business and you do not have any balance, then you would enter zero here. Then we have cash inflow, means how money comes into the business. For that, I have taken two examples. It can be sales revenue, the money you collect after selling your products. It can be cash receivables. We also call them debtors. Now, these are the customers, those have bought our goods on credit and they will give us money after 1 month or 2 months. So we will enter here that. And then the total of cash inflow. Then we have cash outflows. There can be different ways through which money goes out of the business. One can be you have to pay for the raw material. Other can be you pay for the wages, loan repayments if you have taken any kind of loans from the banks. And this gives you the total of 5. Now for net cash flow. Net cash flow is basically the difference between cash inflow and outflow. I have total of cash inflow. I have total of cash outflow. I'll take the difference. That is 1. Then I have closing bank balance. How we calculate that? Opening bank balance, the money we had at the start of the month, and plus net cash flow which we have gained after paying all the expenses, that money that will add up into this. And this gives me the total of 3. Now, it can also happen that sometimes we have more inflows than outflows. Then definitely your net cash will be in negative and you will subtract that from the opening bank balance. And it can be possible that you have closing bank balance in negative. Now I'll discuss about the uses of cash flow statement. Why it is important for the businesses to make this cash flow statement. Even if they have started a new business, it should be done for at least 2 or 3 months. Why it is important. Even for the running businesses, they have to keep on updating their cash flow statement. First of all, it's important to manage their business. For instance, if I have seen that in the month of March, I am getting more cash, I can keep that cash aside to pay for any of the expenses which I will have in April or May, and I have to pay more money for that. So I can keep that money aside. Secondly, to keep sufficient cash. If I have this drawn up properly with me, so I'll know exactly that when I will have cash flow problems, when I will have less cash, so I'll keep some cash aside to pay for any unexpected or any more expenses I have in a specific month. I'll keep my money aside for that purpose. Lastly, to arrange cash. For instance, you have negative bank balance and you have to pay some expenses. Your supplier is not going to give you a more raw material if you are not paying the previous one, so you need definitely money for that. You have to show the statement to your bank manager so that he can make possible for you to have overdraft before you people need this. So that's why it's really important to actually make this cash flow statement, not only for the new businesses but also for the running businesses. For the new businesses, if they have to make this cash flow statement, what they can do, they can see the example of other same kind of businesses and then they can make this cash flow statement. Thank you for watching the video. Happy learning.